Thank you for coming along for the first of these reflective evening prayers. Very different to Book of Common Prayer evening prayer, which I hope some of you have been enjoying online during lockdown. I've not put up a Book of Common Prayer evening prayer this evening because I hope people are going to be live streaming. And when I get home, I will load this onto our website so that people who can't or are not on Facebook can pick it up from our website. So it's all getting used to this new technology, and you will see me using my phone. It's not because I'm being rude and texting anybody during the worship service. It's the only way I can manage to get music playing and live streaming at the same time. So do bear with me. If this goes well, let me know what you think by email after the service tonight or sometime tomorrow. Give me a call or contact me. And if people have enjoyed coming and have enjoyed the atmosphere here, then we will run evening prayer services again, gradually starting to build up what we can do. Anyway, you should all have one of these worship sheets. I've printed it nice and big because I knew it would be a bit dim in here. Just take a moment in quiet to prepare our hearts and minds to worship God. The peace of God be with you all.
And also with you.
The transforming winds of creative life. The passionate flames of justice and love
are the graceful songs of the Christ.
The flights of freedom in movements of truth
are the joyful life of the Spirit.
And so we spend a moment to call to mind those sins which have been our failings throughout this week, for the times that we have spoken harshly to people or not responded when others are in need. And the times that we have failed to do God's bidding of us. Let us remember who we are before the holiness of God as we say together, Holy God, we have failed to live in full the generosity of your grace, the costliness of your love, and the liberation of your free spirit. Forgive us and lead us into life. Amen. God, who is both power and love, forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. The collect for today, which is Bible Sunday, or the last Sunday after Trinity. Let us pray. Blessed Lord, who caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, help us so to hear them, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that through patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and forever hold fast the hope of everlasting life, which you have given us in our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Come now to the psalm set for this evening, which is Psalm 119, not all of it, you'll be pleased to hear, but verses 89 to 96. I'm going to read this quite slowly and you can follow the words on your sheet if you wish to. The Lord exists forever. Your word is firmly fixed in heaven. Your faithfulness endures to all generations. You have established the earth, and it stands fast. By your appointment, they stand today. For all things are your servants. If your law had not been my delight, I would have perished in my misery. I will never forget your precepts, for by them you have given me life. I am yours, save me, for I have sought your precepts. The wicked lie in wait to destroy me, but I consider your decrees. I have seen a limit to all perfection, but your commandment is extremely broad. Going to listen to a version of the Magnificat. readings which are set for today. The first one is from Colossians 3, verses 12 to 17. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom. And with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Here ends the first lesson. Our second lesson is from the Gospel of Matthew, reading chapter 24, verses 30 to 35. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send out his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. See also, when you see all these things, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Here ends the second lesson. Two magnificent pieces of scripture this evening, and of course part of one of the great psalms in the book of Psalms from the Psalter. And there are just a few reflections I want to make from these readings this evening. The first comment I want to make is from the beginning of that reading from Matthew, where we hear about the sign of the Son of Man appearing in heaven and all the tribes of the earth mourning, and us being called to recognise perhaps the signs of the time, the signs of Jesus at work. And we, I think, you know, we could debate all evening what the sign of the Son of Man would be in the heavens, if what we mean is that there'd be a sign in the sky. But how do we read the signs that Jesus is present with us? This morning, I preached quite a political sermon. I was very challenged this week by various things that happened. Debates, some of the political debates have been spiteful and cruel, and the thought that children would ever go hungry in this country. It's bad enough that children are going hungry in the rest of the world. That shouldn't be happening. But the thought that any child would be hungry, or any mother would have to go without food to feed her child in this country, or in this part of this country, is abhorrent to me. I cannot bear the thought of a child going hungry or of a family not being able to access food during the school holidays. Where do we see the signs of Christ in situations that we are living through? Where do we see Christ? I think we see Christ in the kindness and generosity of people, sharing what they have at difficult times. And as much as some of the debates and some of the political challenges that we're facing at the moment have been bitter, and there have been, you know, some strikes below the belt, there have been good people stand up for kindness and generosity and compassion and love and sharing and all the things that Christ would have us do. These are the signs of Christ, and we must not only look for them, but we must be prepared to talk about them, and we must be ready to share them with others. And then the very last line there from this gospel reading: heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Each of us has a limited span of life here on earth. And we pass through this life and we try to live well as Christian people. But the words of Scripture are eternal, God breathed, written by humans, but breathed by God. And these eternal words challenge people in every generation. It's true that they are written and rewritten and just converted into every language under the sun. Well, in fact, not every language yet, but they're working towards that. But we have to look at Scripture and we have to try to work out for ourselves what these ancient words mean for us today. And we have to allow those words to transform us and to use those words not to condemn people, but to liberate people and to help to transform structures and lives that are where people are struggling. I suppose, having said all that, it should really go without saying that the first line of Colossians is really one that we should perhaps know and be able to recall really easily as Christian people. We know ourselves as God's chosen ones, don't we? We know that God knows us by name and he's called us his own. We're baptized into his holy church. And because we are God's chosen ones, because we know that we should be holy and that we are beloved of God, we have to clothe ourselves. I love that idea, that we clothe ourselves. We put on compassion and kindness and humility and meekness and patience. I like the idea that they're not kind of coming from within, that we're actually choosing to put them on. Have a think about that during the week. And if anything that I'm saying this evening strikes you, you know, let's have a conversation about it. Bring me up. We'll have a conversation with each other. And finally, from Psalm 119, this first line: the Lord exists forever. And we know from the beginning of John's Gospel, don't we, that the Word became flesh and the Word dwells among us. Jesus is the Word. So Jesus exists forever, and his word is firmly fixed in heaven. In heaven. I think the word is firmly fixed in our hearts if we allow it to be. It's firmly fixed when we clothe ourselves with compassion and kindness and humility and patience and forgiveness and love. And so we seek always to engage with Scripture, and not just to engage with it, but to reflect upon it and allow it to transform us and encourage us as we do seek to challenge all the unequal structures of this world. Amen. Going to play a version of the Lord's Prayer. So we come to our time of intercessory prayer. We love because he first loved us. God of compassion, you love us with an everlasting love. Your love is all around us. It circles us where we stand. It blesses our days with peace. It touches our lives with gentleness. Your love is behind us, holding past regrets and broken dreams, wrapping our missed chances and mistakes in healing hands. Your love is ahead of us, brightening our pathway and making our footsteps secure, disturbing our complacency and shining on our path as guide and a comforter. Your love is with us, tender and true, gentle and strong, filling our days with hope. Though the way ahead seems hard, may we learn to walk with you and to trust that your love will never let us go. We love because he first loved us. Amen. So, Lord, we pray for your church throughout the world. We remember and give thanks for the word of Holy Scripture to guide us into your ways, to bring us to your truth, to inspire us to do your work, to be courageous and compassionate. So we pray, Lord, for your world and give you thanks for the beauty of it and the provision you make for all of us. We pray for those areas in the world where there is deep poverty, where people will go to bed hungry this evening, where people are thirsty with no access to fresh water, where people have no shelter, nowhere to lay their head. We pray for justice and generosity in our world. Pray, Lord, for our local community and give you thanks for all those who care for neighbours, friends and family. We pray for children who are on their half-term holidays. And we pray for families who do not have enough food. We give you thanks for the work of the food bank and for all those who are seeking to offer help to those in need. We pray that no child would ever go hungry. Pray for those we know who are in need today. We pray for those who are unwell and give you thanks for all those who work in caring. We pray for those who are afflicted by the COVID-19 virus and all those seeking to make them better. Pray for those who work in our hospitals, hospice and nursing homes, and for healthcare workers who work in the community. And in a moment of quiet, we bring before God the names of those we know who need our prayers this evening.
Lord, hear my prayer.
pray for those who have passed through this life, through the veil, and into your nearer presence, Lord. We give you thanks for the inspiration they have been in our lives and for the love we have shared. We pray that we will trust in your eternal word and that one day you will take us home to be with you forever. So we come to the closing responses on your sheet, which you should have there. I invite you to join in with the words in bold type. The night is the cover of your peace, O God, the rhythm of your rest for all your people. The darkness is the cloak of your gentleness, O God. The warmth of your hand around the earth. In its blackness is the sign of your eternity, the never-ending living of your love. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and those you love, today and throughout eternity. Amen. Before we leave this evening, can I just ask you please to leave by the back door? There's hand sanitizer before you leave, and I am obliged to ask you not to go back outside to chat. I'll just put some music on, and please do leave as you feel able, just keeping a 2-meter distance. Good night.